projects that we have today at the Hacking STEM booth at ISTE. I'm joined by my awesome colleague, Dave Micah, and we are here at the Microsoft Hacking STEM Hot Wheel Speedometry Project. Today what we're doing is actually having people come in and they're modifying cars and using those cars to actually measure both the kinetic and potential energy as the cars go through the timing gates. We've had a really amazing morning, and we're seeing all sorts of fascinating designs. Simple ones like this, some really kind of crazy ones that kind of come up and about, and then we have people who have decided that they're going to be the fastest car out there, and they started to actually hot glue gun weights onto this. Each of these cars come down through these tracks, and as they do, we're able to not only calculate the time that they're doing, but then also be able to map and graph the kinetic energy. Hey Dave, why don't you tell me about how that's working?
Okay, so what we have here is one of the Hot Wheels speedometry kits that we've built and we've sensorized. So each one of these is a gate that the car will go through. We know the distance, we know the height, so we can map these energy levels, and then the car provides us with the timestamp. So when we send this through, you'll see all the data replicated in the Excel workbook. So here we go.
Bam! That was pretty fun. Now let's go over and take a look at the graph that it generated. So what you can see here is all the gates. You saw those nine gates, and each one had the time. It also then told us what the collision impact force was. And then here we have the potential and kinetic energy. You want to say a little bit about that?
Yeah, you can see, so gates 1 through 3 are where the first acceleration is, where that first downward force is, and you can see the kinetic energy really goes high. And then 3 to 4 is where it goes through the loop, so you can see where that energy actually drops. And then it kind of gradually drops to the end, and then that final acceleration to 0 is represented right at the end there.
And we're very excited to know that we have 2 right now winner people who are competing, and they've actually gotten their cars to go 1.6 seconds through this track, where the rest of us, our little car, only went 1.9 seconds. So that's what we're doing here at the ISTE booth. We are super excited. Go to aka.ms/hackingstem to get access to this lesson plan and everything else that's in the Hacking STEM portfolio. We'll talk to you soon.